not able to connect. Fine, no problem. We are just going to start the quiz. So the topic of today's quiz, all of you know, is modern age. So whatever we have covered in the class during the modern age, everything we are going to include. Whether those things are there in the book, that doesn't matter. Whatever I have taught in the class, everything will be asked in the quiz. Now let's have a glance at the themes for the quiz tonight. Team Chaucer, having Rita Sharma, Anita Dalal, and Namit Tiwari, all are present.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Team Shakespeare, Manomitas is not present, Madhuri and Naufal. So you two have to take care of your group. Get ready for that. And Team Spencer, Shifali, Vidyut, and Sumana. Then we have Team Milton, Suma, Radhi, Nisha, Kaushik, and Surikani, all are present. And then we have Team Johnson, Deepti, Neeru, and Shyampal Singh is yet to join. So you two have to take care of your group. So I hope all of you are ready.
Yes, sir.
Because all of you are preparing very hard for last 2-3 weeks. So I am sure you all are going to enjoy this speech. So the first round we are going to start. That is book and author's name. You will be displayed the name of the book and you have to tell the author's name. So only those are to reply who are concerned with their turn. No one else to reply. Kindly take a note. So here we are going to start with Team Chaucer. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here is your question. Between the Acts is a novel by?
Virginia Woolf.
Virginia Woolf.
Virginia Woolf.
Okay. Okay, fine.
The wife.
Virginia Woolf is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Chaucer. Congratulations for opening your account.
Thank you.
Wow.
Just make sure that you have only 20 seconds to reply the question. Next question to Team Shakespeare. And here's your question. I, Claudius, is a work by?
Siegfried Sassoon.
Pardon? Tell aloud.
Siegfried Sassoon.
Siegfried Sassoon. Okay.
Robert Graves.
Okay. Robert Graves is the right answer. So as I said that 2 options can be taken. So second option is right. So 5 marks. Bitter,
please.
Abhajona,
please.
So Team Shakespeare got 5 marks. Congratulations to open your account. Now we are going to have questions from Team Spencer. Shifali, Bidut, and Shumana, get ready. Exile is a play by? Exile is a play by. Exiles is a play by. Time is up.
So W.B. Yeats.
W.B. Yeats. So it's Duck for Team Spencer. The right answer is James Joyce.
Sorry, sir.
Next question to Team Milton. Get ready. The Ambassadors is a work by? The Ambassadors. It's a novel by?
Graham Greene. Make sure you're not audible properly.
That's the wrong answer. Right answer is Henry James. So, Hamilton, you need to open your account. It's a request to all the participants that whenever you reply the answer, kindly say the answer aloud. In Johnson, the philanderer is a work by
Glossworthy.
John Glossworthy.
John
Glossworthy.
Yes. Okay. G.B. Shaw.
The philanderer is work by George Bernard Shaw. So, Team Johnson, yes. You have to open your account. Now we are going to have the second turn of the first round. So team Chaucer, get ready. Here is a question. The road to Wigan Pier is an essay by?
George Orwell, sir.
George Orwell. Final?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. George Orwell is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Chaucer. That's great. Next question to Team Shakespeare. The Heart of the Matter is a work by?
Graham Greene.
Graham Greene. Okay.
Graham Greene, sir.
That's right. So 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. With only two, you are fighting very well. Next question to Team Spencer. Team Spencer, yet to open your account. Old Possum's Book of Practical Cats is a collection of poems by
Sir T.S. Eliot. T.S. Eliot.
T.S. Eliot. We have just discussed it one of the day in the
yes, sir.
Itself.
Yes.
So T.S. Eliot is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Spencer. So with this 5 marks, you open your account. Next question to Team Milton. Get ready, and here is your question. The Dance of the Death is a one-act play in verse and prose by The Dance of Death, one act play.
Pardon? G.B. Shaw.
George Bernard Shaw. It's a one act play by W.H. Auden. The Dance of Death is a very famous one act play which is there in verse as well as in prose. Next question to Team Johnson. Be ready. You are still yet to open your account. Plain Tales from the Hill is a collection of short stories by
Sir Kipling. Rudyard Kipling. Kipling.
Rudyard Kipling. Plain Tales from the Hill.
Rudyard Kipling, sir.
Kipling. That's right. So with 5 marks, you open your account.
Thank you, sir.
So we have end of the first round. So Team Chaucer and Team Shakespeare leading with 10 marks. Team Spencer and Team Johnson with 5. And Team Milton yet to open your account. And now we are going to second round where you have to reply the title and subtitles of different works. Team Chaucer, get ready. What is the subtitle of Rudyard Kipling's The White Man's Burden?
Philippines, something like this, sir.
You have to tell the full title. Time is up. Anyone else?
Sir, United States and the Philippines Island.
We'll try the United States and the Philippine Island is the right answer. So, duck to Team Chaucer.
हाँ सर, मैं फिलीपीन तो बताया था सर मैंने. अब इतना ऑप्शन में आएगा तो बता दूंगा सर पूरा. मार्क्स तो मिल रहे हैं सर.
नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू टीम शेक्सपियर. What is the subtitle of the long poem The Age of Anxiety by W.H. Auden?
A Baroque Eclogue, sir.
Baroque Eclogue. Final answer?
Baroque Eclogue, yes, sir.
Baroque Eclogue is right answer. So 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. You are fighting very well. Excellent. Next question to Team Spencer. What is the subtitle of Accent of Essex that is written by W.H. Auden and Christopher Isherwood? Accent of Essex.
A Tragedy of Two Acts.
A Tragedy of Two Acts.
Yes, sir. A Tragedy in Two Acts. A Tragedy in Two Acts.
A Tragedy in Two Acts is the right answer. That's brilliant. So 5 marks to Team Spencer. Hey, Milton, yet to open your account. Here is your question. What is the subtitle of Orlando?
A Biography.
Biography.
Orlando, A Biography.
That's the right answer. So it is 5 marks. You open your account. And next question to Team Johnson. What is the subtitle of To the Lighthouse?
Time passes.
Time passes.
Time passes. That's a brilliant answer by Team Johnson. So 5 marks again to Team Johnson. Now we are going to have the second turn of the second round. And this question to Team Chaucer. Which historical novel of Robert Graves is based on a true story on the life of the young wife of poet John Milton, having the subtitle Wife to Mr. Milton? This was published in 1943. Subtitle is given. You have to tell the name, title of this historical novel by Robert Graves.
Robert Graves novel.
This novel is based on the wife of John Milton.
Sir, the story of Mary Powell. The story of Mary Powell.
Story of Mary Powell. Story of Mary Powell is right answer. Brilliant answer. I think Chaucer. So 5 marks. 15 Chaucer. It's a very famous novel and it's important as well because there is a depiction of John Milton's wife. Next question to Team Shakespeare. Playing very well. What is the subtitle of Nostromo by Joseph Conrad?
The tale of sea bound, sir.
All of you kindly.
Tale of seaboard, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nisha.
Tale of seaboard is right.
ये मैंने बोला है सर निशा ने seaboard.
We have said.
Time up होने के बाद.
सर मैंने already दे दिया था सर answer.
Bouncer, sea bouncer बोला था मधु ने.
Me and Madhuri ma'am said.
I think seaboard, you had not said seaboard. I could not hear seaboard.
No, yes, sir. I already said, sir. My son is making me sir.
She says bouncer, not seaboard.
Yes, I also heard the same. A tale of bouncer.
Yes, sir. So seaboard nahi bola tha.
I could not give marks to Team Shakespeare this time.
Sir, Madhuri ma'am.
Kindly say your answer aloud. Next question to Team Spencer. Which novel of H.G. Wells is having the subtitle The Story of a Simple Soul?
Ah.
The Story of a Simple Soul.
Sir, the Time Machine. Time Machine.
No, sir. Kipps.
Kipps, sir. Kipps.
Kipps. Yes, sir. Kipps.
अरे मैं हूँ. Over हो गया था time.
Okay, time is up. So, Duck to Team Spencer. Kipps is the right answer. Next question to Team Milton. What is the subtitle of Nigger of Narcissus?
A Tale of Sea, sir.
A Tale of the Sea.
Tale of the Sea is right answer. So 5 marks to Team Milton. Coming back on the track, Team Johnson. What is the subtitle of Animal Farm?
Sir, a fairy story.
A fairy story is right answer. 5 marks to Team Johnson.
Thank you, sir.
So we end with the second round. At the end of the second round, Team Chaucer, Team Milton, and Team Johnson. Sorry, Team Chaucer, Team Shakespeare, and Team Johnson all are at 15 points, whereas Team Spencer and Milton at 10 points. A very tight competition going on here. Let's see in the third round, which is about year of publication. This is the most difficult round. So let's see how many of you are able to reply the questions. Team Chaucer, and here's your question. 1984, the novel was published in which year?
It's 1949.
That's right. 1949 is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Chaucer. Next question to Team Shakespeare. The Playboy of the Western World. That's a novel published in which year? This is a play published in which year?
1907.
That's the right answer by Nopal. So again, 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Team Spencer. Sons and Lovers or Paul Morrell was published in which year?
Sir, 1913.
I think there is some error in the answer.
No, sir.
1913.
Yes, yes. You're right. There is some error in the answer.
Yes.
I also remember it's 1913. I think
yes,
there is
yes,
a...
Yes, sir. 1913. Yes, sir.
Yeah, this it's my error. It's 1913 is the right answer. So okay, Team Spencer will get 5 marks. Is wrong. I think there is a typing mistake. Okay, now moving on to Team Milton. Morris is a novel by E.M. Forster. It is Tale of Homosexual Love. Published in which year?
1971, sir.
That's brilliant. Very fast. It was written in 1913-14, revised in 1932 and 59-60, and published in 1971. So 5 marks to Team Milton. Next question to Team Johnson. Sonnet, Leda and the Swan by W.B. Yeats was published in which year?
Nineteen twenty-four.
Okay. Was published in 1924. That's right. It was composed in 1923, but published in the collection yes. "The Cat and the Moon and Certain Poems" in 1924. So 5 marks to Team Johnson. That's a brilliant answer. Next question to Team Chaucer. We are on the second turn of the third round. The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock by T.S. Eliot published in which year?
1913.
उसके बाद 1917 में थ्रू फर्क अंडर देयर ऑब्जर्वेशन के
यस वेरी राइट सो 5 मार्क्स टू टीम चॉसर दैट्स ब्रिलियंट आंसर नाउ टीम शेक्सपियर जंगल बुक बाय रुडयार्ड कपलिंग वाज पब्लिश्ड इन व्हिच ईयर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम
1893
is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. Now we are going to have Team Spencer. This is Dalloway by Virginia Woolf was published in which year?
1925.
1925, yes, sir. 1925 is right answer. 5 marks to Team Spencer. Now we are going to have the next question to Team Milton. Women in Love. By D.H. Lawrence, published in which year?
1920.
Yes, sir. 1920. Yes, sir. 1920. Okay. 1920. Yes, sir. Okay, fine. Let's see. 1920 is the right answer. So 5 marks again to Team Milton. Next question to Team Johnson. Dubliners, which is a collection of short stories by James Joyce, published in which year?
1914.
So fast. That's brilliant preparation. 1914 is the right answer. 5 marks again to Team Johnson.
Milton, sir.
So now we are end with the third round. At the end of third round, Team Chaucer, Team Shakespeare, Team Johnson, all are at 25. Team Spencer and Team Milton with 20, just 5 marks behind. That's a very tight fight going on between all the teams. Now we are going to play the fourth round. All of you played a very well, all of you replied all the questions related to the year. This was the biggest fear when I started the quiz.
Yes, sir.
Now we all are
close to you.
So much focus that I am very happy because this is the main problem with most of the scholars that they are not able to recall the year of publication.
So Ali now we are. Later, year dikh jaye sir relate karne lag jaate
hain. That's brilliant. This is the strategy and. This is the thing that I wanted to develop inside you, and you are going very well. Now let's see the setting. You will be asked the setting of the questions. Team Chaucer, which novel is set on 3 generation of Brangwen family?
It's Rainbow, sir. Rainbow.
Rainbow.
Rainbow. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Rainbow.
Okay. The rainbow is right answer. So 5 marks to Team Chaucer. Next question to Team Shakespeare. Which novel is set in Isle of Skye in Scotland between 1910 and 1920?
Virginia Woolf novel, sir.
Name of the novel.
Lighthouse.
Time is up.
Lighthouse, sir.
Okay, I'll take your call to the lighthouse is right answer. So 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Team Spencer. In which one act play, Karl Marx appear on the stage and pronounces a dancer's death?
Sir, a dance of the death, W.H. Auden.
A dance of the death by W.H. Auden. That's brilliant and fastest answer. That's brilliant. 5 marks to Team Spencer. Very good preparation. Next question to Team Milton. Which novel is based on the characters Whiskey Price, who is living in the Mexican state of Tabasco in
1930s? Graham Greene's.
Pardon?
Graham Greene's Power and the Glory.
Graham Greene's Power and the Glory.
Power and the Glory, yes, sir. Graham Greene.
That's right. Power and the Glory is the right answer. 5 marks to Team Milton. All of you are going great. Next question to Team Johnson. Which one act tragedy is set in the Aran Island in Ishmael?
Sea wala, sir. Death by sea something, sir.
Yes, you are close. Death, very close. You are very close.
Sea of the death, sir.
No, sir. No.
St. John.
Time is up. Anyone else?
A riders to sea,
riders
sir.
Riders to the sea.
Yeah.
Do not reach there, so you'll not get marks for this. You're very close, but could not recall that title.
Yes, sir.
Okay, no problem. Then let's see the second round. Tim Chaucer, what is the meaning of Geronchin by T.S. Eliot?
A little old man.
Yes, sir.
Little old man is the right answer.
Yes, sir.
Little. 5 marks to Team Chaucer. You are going very well today. Next is Team Shakespeare. Team Shakespeare, what is the title of the play which a group of actors are preparing to rehearse in Luigi Pirandello's play 6 characters in search of an author?
So mixing it up.
Yes.
Mixing it up.
Oh, that's too fast. Before I start the timer, you just reply, mixing it up is the right answer. So 5 marks again to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Team Spencer. Which play revolves around the 3 main characters, Aston, Mick, and Davis?
Sir, The Caretaker. Caretaker.
Caretaker by Harold Pinter.
Yes, sir.
That's brilliant preparation. Tim Spencer, 5 marks again. Next question to Tim Milton. Which novel of George Orwell is set in 1920s Imperial Burma in the fictional district of Kayathada?
Burmese Days, sir.
Burmese Days, right.
Burmese Days is right.
So
5 marks to Tim Milton. All of you are prepared very well. I am so happy today. Tim Johnson, which is the second play of Ciano Casey's Dublin Trilogy?
The Juno and the Peacock.
Brilliant. It's the fastest speed. Juno and the Peacock is the right answer.
Thank you, sir.
Now we have finished the 4th round. At the end of 4th round, Team Chaucer and Team Shakespeare leading with 35. Whereas race 3 at tied 30 points. Now we are going to start the 5th round, which is the opening, ending, and some other quotations. In Chaucer, identify the opening lines from the novel. It was a bright, cold day in April and the clock was striking 13.
Sir, it's... कौन सा था? एक तो Big Brother वाला. George Orwell.
1984. Yes, sir. 1984. Yes, sir. 1984 is the right answer.
So, 5 marks to Team Chaucer. Namit is rocking today.
No, yes, sir.
No, sir. No, it's a combined effort. Team, well. Yes, sir. Team effort.
She gives me clue. She gives me clue. I remember the name. She remember that.
Definitely, this is how team works.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Next to Team Shakespeare, identify the opening line. Let's go then, you and I.
Sir, 1984. George Orwell. No, sir. This is T.S. Eliot, sir. T.S. Eliot.
Name of?
Proof Rock. Love song of J. Alfred Proof Rock.
Okay, fine. So the second answer was right. Because just now we have seen the first question of 1984. So the, one more can't have two opening lines. So Love Song of J. Alfred Proof Rock is right. 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Team Spencer. Identify the opening lines of the poem. What passing bells are those who die as cattle? Only the monstrous anger of the gun.
Sir, Anthem for Doomed Youths.
Anthem for the Doomed Youths?
Sir, Anthem for Doomed Youths.
That's right. Yes, it's sir. By Wilfred Owen. That's brilliant. 5 marks to Team Spencer. Yes. Next question to Team Milton. Identify the opening lines of the novel. Once upon a time and a very good time, it was there was a mock cow coming down along the road.
James Joyce. Yeah. Artist.
Young artist, like, yeah.
Yes.
The art, the portrait of a young artist, young man.
Portrait of artist as young man.
Yes, portrait of the artist as a young man. So finally, you come with the right title. Portrait of the artist as a young man is the right answer. Next question to Team Johnson. Identify the opening line of the poem. April is the cruelest month, breeding lilacs out of the dead land.
T.S. Eliot, sir. Westland, sir. T.S. Eliot.
Westland is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Johnson. Now we are going to have the second turn of the fifth round. Team Chaucer. Identify the epigraph of the novella. Brother to a prince and fellow to beggar, if he be found worthy.
Girls worthy. Little beggar. Rudyard Kipling, sir. Rudyard Kipling. Novella hai to. Kaun sa hai ye novella?
Time is up. Kipling ka hai. Anyone else?
Who would be the king, sir?
Man who would the king, sir?
Who, that's yes, sir. The man who would the man who king.
Would be king.
But time the was man, up, so yes, you will not get any marks for that.
Yeah.
Next question to Team Shakespeare.
At the last time, Namit sir said.
Identify the novel. I am not a sahib. I am thy chela. Team Shakespeare.
George Orwell.
No. Sir, this is Kipling, I think.
Name of the novel.
Kipling. Kim, sir, Kim.
Okay.
Kim.
Kim is right, so 5 marks too. You just replied in the last second.
Sir, we also should get the marks, sir.
Your timer was actually stopped completely. next question to team Spencer. Identify this poem. No, I am not Prince Hamlet, nor was meant to be.
Sir, T.S. Eliot, Alfred J. Prufrock.
Alfred J. Prufrock is the right answer.
The love song of Alfred J. Prufrock.
That's fine. 5 marks to Team Spencer. Next question to Team Milton. Identify this poem. This is the way the world ends, not with a bang, but a whimper.
Sorry,
anyone else?
The Hollow Man.
By T.S. Eliot. This line is repeated 3 times. This is the way the world ends. This is the way the world ends. This is the way the world ends. Not with a bang, but a whimper. This is a very famous line from The Hollow Man. Next question to Team Johnson. Identify this poem. Once more, the storm is howling, and half hid under the squirrel hood and cover lead, my child slips on.
The prayer of the daughter.
Prayer of my daughter.
Yes, the prayer of my daughter. Yes.
It's by W.B. Yeats. A prayer for my daughter. Yes. That's the right answer. So 5 marks. Team Johnson.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now we are end with the 5th round. And at the end of the 5th round, now Team Shakespeare leading with 45. That's brilliant. Congratulations, Team Shakespeare. And Team Chaucer and Team Spencer with 40. Team Johnson's also 40 and Team Milton with 35. Still, the competition is very tight. Round 6, identify protagonists and the characters. First question to Team Chaucer. In which poem the character Scalps, the Phoenician sailor who has died apparently by drowning, appears?
वेस्टलैंड सर टी एस एलियट वेस्टलैंड का पॉलिसियन का जो थी पहली फर्स्ट पोएम सर फर्स्ट पोएम नाम बताने सर पोएम का
नो वेस्टलैंड इज एनफ
फर्स्ट सर
द वेस्टलैंड इज राइट इट्स डेथ बाय वाटर इट्स द
डेथ बाय वाटर सर
इट्स द फोर्थ पोएम इन व्हिच द सेल्बस अपीयर्स
यस सर
सो 5 marks टू टीम चॉकलेट
आई वाज कंफ्यूज्ड सर वेस्टलैंड बोलना है Another poem. So
the name of the poem is Wasteland only. If I could have asked Death by Water, then I would have asked the section. Yes. Section of the Wasteland. The next question to Team Shakespeare.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Character Big Brother appears in which novel?
This 1984, sir. Orwell.
George Orwell, sir.
George Orwell, 1984. That's brilliant. 5 marks again to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Team Spencer. Pinky Brown is the anti-hero of which novel?
Sir, Brighton Rock.
Brighton Rock?
Brighton Rock, yes, sir.
Brighton Rock by Graham Greene is the right answer. That's brilliant. All of you are doing brilliant today. Next question to Team Milton. Which novel is the adventures of the two characters? One is named the owner of the voice and the second is the botanist.
Sir,
करनी पड़े
तुमा
नहीं यार, जो यार नहीं है। Anyone
else? The first man in the moon.
Very, that's H.G. Wells, modern utopia.
Utopia.
Yes.
Okay.
This name is quite the typical type. That is the reason it is famous one.
Yes, sir.
So Tim Milton will not get any marks for this. Next question to Tim Johnson. Giants Scylla and Charybdis appears in which novel?
Odysseus and Charybdis, sir.
We are not reading classical literature.
Most.
Time is up.
Steam.
Anyone else?
It's an absurd play.
One thing is very sure that when we were reading the classical literature, these giants also appeared there. Scylla and Charybdis.
Yes. Leda and so on wale mein bhi matlab classical literature yes, wale aaye
the. They appeared when we were discussing Homer Odyssey.
Yes, sir.
And Odyssey and Ulysses, both are same novels, as I said.
Yes, sir. Yes, James Joyce.
So, Ulysses.
James Joyce.
Ulysses is the right answer. Now, we are going on to the second turn. Tim Chaucer, Gudrun is the character from which novel?
Yeah, Gudrun, sir. The Rainbow and second one. The Woman in Love, sir.
Women in Love. Very right. So 5 marks to Team Chaucer. Next question to Team Shakespeare. Mary Carmichael is a fictional character displaying lesbianism in women. Which work?
A room of one's own.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Wo four sisters thi na. Wo marry or
very right.
No, it's a fourth part of a room of one's own.
Yes. Room of one's own is right. So 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Tina Spencer. Mr. McBride is a police superintendent, a character from which novel?
Sir, Passage to India.
Passage to India. That's right. He is the first character who appears in the novel.
Yes, sir.
Tina Spencer, 5 marks.
Thank you, sir.
All of you are doing great today. Next question to Tim Milton. Agamemnon is a character from which poem?
Leda and Swan,
yes.
That's right. Leda and Swan is the right answer. So 5 marks to Tim Milton. Last question of the 6th round to Team Johnson. Which comedy play centers around the fortunes of Mr. Edward Chamberlain and Lavinia Chamberlain? Which comedy play centers around fortunes of Mr. Edward Chamberlain and Lavinia Chamberlain?
Cocktail Party
by T.S. Eliot.
Yes, sir.
That's right. 5 marks to Team Johnson.
Thank you, Neeru.
All of you are prepared very well. That's brilliant. So now we have finished the 6th round. At the end of the 6th round, Team Shakespeare is leading with 55 marks.
Team Chaucer and Team Spencer with 50. And Team Johnson 45 and Team Milton with 40 marks. The seventh round, origin of the works and who coined the term. Team Chaucer, get ready. Here is your question. The term stream of consciousness was coined by?
Virginia Woolf. Virginia Woolf.
James. William James.
Virginia Woolf ka work tha aur coin kisi aur ne ki.
James.
Kindly say the final answer.
William James, sir. James.
Sir, I could. Virginia Woolf.
William James in his Principle of Psychology. Yes. 5 marks to Team Chaucer.
No problem.
Next question to Team Shakespeare. The phrase objective correlative was first coined by which American painter and poet?
T.S. Eliot.
Kindly read the question again. The phrase objective correlative was first coined by which American painter and poet? Time is up. Anyone else?
Washington Alston.
Very right. Washington Alston has used this term for the first time. So Team Shakespeare will not get any marks for this time. Team Spencer, literally, the term comedy of menace was first coined by?
Sir, Irving Waddell.
Irving Waddell. That's right answer. 5 marks to Team Spencer. Next question to Team Milton. The term historical consciousness was coined by?
Virginia Woolf.
That's brilliant.
Virginia Woolf.
The answer in a second. That's right answer. 5 marks to Team Milton. Next question to Team Johnson. The term Victorian compromise was coined by?
G.K. Chesterton.
G.K. Chesterton. In some of the books, you will find Lawrence Friedman.
Lawrence Friedman, yes.
So both have the right answer. So Team Johnson will get 5 marks.
Thank you, sir.
Next to Team Chaucer again. The title Eyeless in Gaza by Aldous Huxley has the title originates from a phrase in which work of John Milton?
Samson Agonistes,
is the right answer. Really, Namit is rocking today.
Oh, however, I was blank, sir. I thought another deep question, sir. I was kept quiet.
Okay.
Today I'm not well, sir.
Yes, so you are still in doctor's clinic, I think.
but still she is great help, sir. Without her, I don't think we are able to achieve this much score.
Okay, next question between Shakespeare. Imagist was a movement in modernist Anglo-American poetry that originated in which year? Imagist movement.
Oh my god, 1912
is the right answer. That's brilliant. Next question to Team Spencer. Surrealism is a cultural movement that emerged in Paris in 1924 as a direct result of the publication of Manifesto on Surrealism.
Sir Henri Breton.
Right answer. Yes. That. Before I finish the question, you have replied the answer. That's great.
Yes, sir.
Next question to Team Milton. The title Brave New World by Aldous Huxley has been derived from which work?
Shakespeare's The Tempest.
Tempest by Shakespeare is the right answer. 5 marks to Team Milton. And next question to Team Johnson. This is the last question of the seventh round. The term Electra complex finds its origin in the classical tragedian. Identify the two classical tragedians who wrote for this term under the same title.
Sophocles and
Homer.
D. H. Lawrence.
Classical tragedian.
No, Oedipus Rex.
The question was, they wrote under the same title. The title was Electra.
Yes, sir. The one is by Sophocles.
Sophocles and Euripides.
Euripides, yes.
So you will get 2.5 marks for this question.
Sorry, time full kar do.
Now we are finished with the seventh round. At the end of the seventh round, team Chaucer, team Shakespeare, team Spencer all are tying with 60 marks. Whereas team Johnson with 52.5 and team Milton with 50. So this shows that all of you are preparing well and you all are taught by the same teacher. This is
yes.
Yes, sir.
Next is eighth round, which is a surprise round. Anything can be asked in this round. I hope this round is going to make some difference. The first question to Team Chaucer. Which Edwardian monarch only ruled for 11 months?
George VI, sir. No, King Edward VIII
is right. He only ruled for 11 months, so 5 marks to Chaucer. Next question to Team Shakespeare. Rudyard Kipling was born in which city?
Motihari Bihar.
Motihari Bihar. Who was born in Motihari?
George Orwell.
अगर
और किसी को ये क्वेश्चन आ गया तो सर उसको मार्क्स मिल जाएंगे.
सर बॉम्बे सर.
She's confused.
Next question to Team Spencer. Which poem of Rudyard Kipling carried the essence of the message of the Gita according to Khushwant Singh?
If.
That's
if,
right.
Sir.
If is the right answer. 5 marks to Team Spencer. Next question to Team Milton. In the science fiction dystopian novella, The Time Machine, protagonist visits back to which century?
AD 802 or 701, sir?
Century.
Century.
Sir, 18th century.
8th century?
9th century ho jayegi.
8th and 9th, both are right. So 5 marks to Team Milton.
Thank you, sir.
Next question to Team Johnson. Which is the second section of the Westland?
The game of the chess.
Yeah, the game of chess, sir.
Very right. Excellent. Game of chess is right. 5 marks to Team Johnson. Now we are going to have the second turn. The term epiphany was introduced by James Joyce in which work? Pardon?
Ulysses and.
The term epiphany means sudden realization. This was introduced by James Joyce.
Yes,
Stephen
Dedalus, this may, sir. Ulysses.
No, Stephen Hero. Stephen Hero was appointed after a man. Which one, ma'am? अपोर्टेट ऑफ एन आर्टिकल
जी सर ये
नो सर नो
यस यस
नो
नहीं सर जेम्स जॉयस का यूलिसिस एंड वो सर स्टीफन
डबलिनर्स डबलिनर्स
डबलिनर्स इज द राइट आंसर सो यू विल गेट 0 फॉर दिस दिस वाज द कलेक्शन ऑफ शॉर्ट स्टोरीज इन व्हिच ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द स्टॉर्म एपिफैन Next question to Team Shakespeare. How many commandments were there for the animals in the animal farm?
Seven
is the right answer. So 5 marks to Team Shakespeare. Next question to Team Spencer. Which is the only tragedy play by George Bernard Shaw?
Saint John
is right. Next question to T. Milton. In which essay of Virginia Woolf defines an analogy between the act of writing and fishing?
Professions for women.
The profession for women, sir.
Very fast. That's brilliant. Profession for women is the right answer. Who wrote novels under the pseudonym Nicholas Blake?
Cecil McLeod.
Cecil D. Lewis is the right answer. Now we are finished with 8th round. And at the end of the 8th round, Team Spencer is leading with 70 marks. Team Chaucer and Shakespeare with each with 65 and Team Johnson with 62.5 and Milton with 60. Now we are going to have the rapid fire round and I will be very much careful that once the answer is displayed and after that you reply, your marks will not be counted. So Team Chaucer, be ready. You will get only 10 seconds. Okay. And here your question starts.
Petrarchan sonnet, sir. Petrarchan sonnet. I am not even.
Who is the mother of Paul Morrell in Sons in Lover?
What gratitude moral gratitude
acha wo agya Pygmalion has been taken from classical work
Ovid's metamorphosis
Malice in Wonderland is a novel by
Louise MacNeice
Alice Hoga sir Cecil D. Lewis Alice Hoga sir ye Sailing to Byzantium, in which meter? Ottawa Rima.
So this was your 5 questions. You could reply only 3 out of 5.
Sir, Alice in Wonderland.
Alice is also a separate novel. Alice in Wonderland.
Sir, 4.
Sir, 4. Only mother of Paul Morrell nahi aata tha, sir.
No, no. अरे वो बताया था मैंने. अरे वो मैंने बताया था Gertrude Morrell बताया था मैंने वो.
Yes. You replied, but
आने लग गया था. Answer appear हो गया था, sir. Second question का. बाकी 4 हमने दिए थे, sir.
Okay. You could not reply Gertrude Morrell and Cecil D. Lewis. These 2 answers you could not reply.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir, Malice, मैंने बोला Alice in Wonderland, Cecil D. Lewis. ऐसे हुआ.
No problem, Rita.
कि मुझे लगा spelling problem.
Next 2 teams, Shakespeare. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Last.
We did well.
Sir, W.B. Yeats.
What name?
Second what? Coming. Italy, sir. Chile. Italy. Italy.
Four Tempters.
Four Tempters.
George Orwell.
George Orwell. Quotes, sir. Quotes by that person, Kipling. The name is Heart of Darkness.
So at the end of the five questions, you could reply only three.
Sir.
The first.
Sir.
No, for second coming, you only replied after the answer appeared. And the last question, the Heart of Darkness, you're very close, but you cannot recollect the title.
Yes, sir.
Now, next, turn to Team Spencer. Get ready? And here your question starts.
Stephen Spender. Orlando and biography. Bannasso.
England, social organism.
At the end of the five questions, you could reply only one question.
Sir, because of network problem, so sorry. There is no network. I said no.
Okay, that may be the problem, but the questions were very simple,
okay,
what I feel.
Don't worry. It's okay, sir.
Because Rudyard Kipling was the first British who received the Nobel Prize.
Yes, sir. I know the answer. Yes, sir, I know. But so sorry. Because of network problem.
Okay, next turn to Team Milton. Get ready.
Mrs. Dalovis.
Mrs. Dalovis.
Howardson by
React, sir. Oh shit. Undershroud is a character on novel Shroud.
Oh my god. Unne discuss kiya tha na yaar.
Haan yaar, mujhe yaad tha. Oh shit. Plumed serpent is at ye tha Mexico. It's Mexico. Oh, three.
Okay, so you are end with the five questions. You could reply three questions out of five.
Yes, sir. Barbara bhul gayi.
The last to Team Johnson. Be ready.
Sir, arms and the men.
Arms and the men, sir.
The metaphysical poets.
Yes, sir. Traditional and individual talent. Martin Heslin, sir. मार्टिन एसलिन 1960
The strong strength of emotions. Arnold Bennett.
Arnold. At the end of the four questions, you could reply four out of five.
Yes,
the tradition and individual theory of personal.
Yes.
So with this, we finished the quiz, and now it's time to get your feedback. What was the standard of the questions, and what was the standard of your preparation? I feel very happy today because there is a lot of improvement in comparison to last two quizzes.
Yes,
there were too many
questions.
Sare
questions. Aap kitna matlab total question ka number kya hai?
Around total questions were 21 questions.
21. Okay.
So you could maximum get 105.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We know that these questions will definitely come in, and even though we revise now, memory plays a role.
और सर जो mistake करते हैं वो तो अच्छे से learn हो जाते हैं.
We enjoyed it a lot, sir. मतलब.
Yes. The one thing is there ki if you are mistaking any question wo fir kabhi bhulogi nahi like
yes sir
yes sir
questions aate matlab answer pata hota hai par pata nahi sudden kya ho jata hai 20 second mein sir nahi aata
itna time clock ka itna pressure hota hai ki
seriously
aate aate pata nahi mind mein kya aana shuru ho jata hai
so much stress
But I am really very happy that you prepared, all of you prepared very well. And the way you are replying, if you are replying same way in the exam, फिर कोई रोक नहीं सकता है आपको GRF लेने से.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Within a second. आता है तो, एक second में answer आ जाता है sir, कई बार तो.
Exactly.
हाँ, आता है तो तुरंत आ जाता है sir.
हाँ जी. Thank you so much, sir.
Brilliant question, sir.
Yes, sir. So you are doing
so what is the result?
Really hard work for us.
Yeah, well, of course, my hard work is... but I am very happy that my hard work is fulfilled. Once you all are replying.
But sir, no, sir. Se, sir not up to the mark, help mil rahi hai, so.
Yes, definitely.
Up to the mark, nahi ho raha, sir. Itne preparation nahi kara, sir.
Yes, I'm sir. Not this happy. Time, I'm not happy with Rita.
yes sir I am also not happy with me sir
so today
the morning session sir do doctor ke ja chuki hu aur kal fir jana hai itna pareshan
here is the final score team spencer with 75 team johnson with top with 82.5 congratulations team johnson
congratulations
sir hum top pe aa gaye aa gaye top pe hame to lag nahi raha tha chaucer honge chaucer
great job
so many congratulations to Deepti and Neeru
thank you
finally in the rapid fire round you replied 4 out of 5
sir aaj pata nahi aaj main bahut zyada panic ho gayi thi
सर मॉर्निंग में भी हमने रिवीजन नहीं की सर वो क्लास अटेंड करने
सर आज यहाँ पर
यस पेपर भी
था रनर इज टीम चॉसर एंड टीम शेक्सपियर विद 80 सो अगेन कांग्रेचुलेशन टू बोथ द टीम्स टीम शेक्सपियर आई वाज रियली वरीड दैट मनोमिता इज नॉट देयर हाउ दे विल एबल टू परफॉर्म बट नोफेल एंड माधुरी बोथ ऑफ देम ब्रिलियंट
दे डिड ग्रेट जॉब
सर दिस टाइम नोफेल सर ने काफी मतलब अच्छा किया
स्प्लेंडिड परफॉर्मेंस Really.
Seriously.
So all of you did very well. You all are very close to each other. That's a really fruitful competition that I'll say.
No, sir. It's 75 only for Milton.
But you're very close. Means the marks are very close.
Four two and a half marks. Yes, sir.
हाँ यार एक क्वेश्चन हाँ सेवन
यार
हाँ एक ही क्वेश्चन का हो रहा है
केवल एक क्वेश्चन का ही डिफरेंस नॉट अ बिग डिफरेंस